Ever wondered if your Raise has more LEDs than your friends' keyboards? Time to know the answer and win the argument once and for all. Hi Digmates, Dominique here. Today we're going to find out more about the LEDs on your keyboard, how they work, and some tips on how to use them for more than just their cool looks. So the Raise uses RGB LEDs. Okay, fine. Let me be more descriptive. RGB is a color model, an additive color model, which means that more colors can be created by adding the basic ones together. In this case, you might have guessed it, the basic colors are red, green, and blue. The scheme looks like this. You can see how the combination of the three colors results in white in the middle, and how the colors cyan, magenta, and yellow appear in the inner edge of the circles when we combine the basic colors. So starting with three, we end up with seven. Meh. RGB doesn't seem that impressive. But what happens if we can control the intensity of each color through the LEDs? Well, the palette increases, looking more like this. Much better. But that doesn't even describe how many colors we can create. Let's put it in numbers, and let's do the math together. So we can control 256 grades of intensity for each LED. We have three LEDs. So what's 256 cubed? We get 16,777,216 colors. Now that number is way more impressive than the seven we started with. Well done, RGB. So each RGB unit underneath each key has three LEDs. One red, one green, and one blue. Now how many RGB units does the Raise have? There are 68 keys on the ANSI layout and 69 on the ISO layout, and there are 63 RGBs for the underglow, which leaves us with a maximum total of 132 RGB units. This translates to 396 individual LEDs. Controlling all of the LEDs uses a lot of pins, and it became a problem when designing the keyboard in the beginning. At that point, we faced two solutions. Use clever LEDs with some processing power inside, or use plain LEDs, but do a hell lot of research in order to make them work how we intended them to. Finally, we went with the plain LEDs. It took a while to figure out, but it was worth it. We ended up not only reducing the overall cost of the keyboard, but also its energy consumption. If you're interested in learning how this process worked, who better to explain it than our former CTO himself, Matt? At this point, you're probably asking, why are there so many LEDs? Why the effort? Is it just to make it look cool? Is it bragging rights for having more LEDs per inch than any other keyboard? Not really. I mean, sure, it looks really cool and appealing. And since all of the LEDs are configurable, you can configure them to be whatever color you want. Yeah, so you can pimp it up. But the real reason they're there is actually to help you with some of the Raise keyboard's functionalities. For example, when it comes to changing layers, they can serve as a visual guide. I talk about this more in the video here. If you're into touch typing, you can use different colors to signal which keys you have to strike with each finger. If you're not into touch typing, what are you waiting for? Take a look at this video and start improving your touch typing with some advice from our CEO. If you use your LEDs for any other purpose or you have a cool lighting setup, let us know in the comments section or share it with our Digmates in our subreddit, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. If you haven't found your perfect setup yet, check out our social channels. Maybe you can find some inspiration there. You might get pleasantly surprised by all the wonderful things our community has to offer. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe for more content and lighting in your life, because there's never enough of it.